Sometimes it's just easier to read this than to read this, like a lot easier. Reading forces you to go from point A to point B, which in some cases helps you better understand the contextual information, like having the full story. Every week I've taken the habits of translating abstract numbers into what it could mean for the business of my clients. It's time consuming, but today let's improve the process to save time and focus on what really matters. So let's do it.
My name is Jeremy Cormoran. I'm a Belgian maker living in the Bay Area, sharing a few thoughts, my ideas, my work, and simply what I do.
Let's have a look at a classic report I'm sending to a client. I usually start this way. Summary of the result. It's just the key numbers. The purchase pain, because the client likes to have an idea of what he's paying for. Then I go into more details for each stage of the customer journey, starting with the awareness phase, the acquisition of traffic, the activation, the revenue. And then I write some key insight. It's just what I've learned from this report. Finally, I do some suggestions of improvements to get better results for the following weeks. Sometimes I write some questions for the client or even a to-do list. So our challenge is to improve the reporting process to increase efficiency so our business can allocate more time in more valuable tasks to help our clients. I'm going to break down all the steps to help you do that. The data architecture describes how the data is processed, store and utilize in our system. In other words, we are going to design how the data flows into our system. So let's say I want to report the Facebook performances of a campaign to a client. I start to think about a convenient way to get the data. We are not going to export CSVs because I don't want to do that. It's crappy, boring. Instead, I found Advironics. It's a plugin for Google Sheets and it's going to do the job. Then I want a document that I'm able to edit. For that, I'm going to use Coda. And then I'm going to use Zapier to send the data from Google Sheets to Coda and Coda to Google Sheets. And then I'm going to use Gmail's regulation to send the report by email. As a marketer, you need to define the KPIs that are meaningful for your clients. It would make sense to make a whole video to describe what are the good metrics to use, but I'm not going to do that now. Instead, I'm just going to tell you what are the metrics I'm going to pick. Reach, impression, frequency, cost of results, results, amount spent, CPM, link clicks, CPC, CTR. In practice, it means that I'm going to create 5 tables in Coda and Google Sheets. One table to sum all the metrics for all the campaigns. One table to break down all the metrics per campaign. Because I want to compare 2 periods of time, I'm going to copy those 2 tables. And finally, I'm going to use a tiny table to control the time ranges from Coda. Once I have all these tables in Coda and Google Sheets, I'm going to use Zapier to map each field together. The reason I like Coda is because there are 2 key differences with a spreadsheet program like Excel. The first one is Coda does not use sales coordinates. Instead, it's using tables, columns, and rows. In the beginning, that's true, it's a little confusing, but with some practice, it's getting easier because cells do not tell much, but a table and a column have names and rows have contextual details. The second reason is that I can write a formula as I write a story. It's called chaining. So it starts mentioning the table I need, the part of the table I need, and finally the action I want to perform. So the first thing I need to do is to push the data into Coda. Advironics needs to know what is the date range. So I'm going to create 2 date range pickers in Coda. I just need to type in a slash, then control, then date range. I do that once again for the second date range picker, so I can compare 2 periods of times. Then I need to save the data of the date range pickers into a table. One column for the starting and one column for the end date. And then I'm going to do that once again for the comparison period. For each column, I'm going to create a formula to enter the selected date ranges. In this case, the formula is really simple. I just need to select the object, which is the date range picker 1, and then mentioning the function I want to perform, which is, in this case, taking the first value. So the function is first. I need to repeat the same formula for the second column, but instead of taking the first value, I'm going to take the last value, and then I create an action to push those date range into Google Sheets, and for that I'm going to create a zap. So I have the data into Coda, now I'm going to create my textual reports to be able to read my reports, to understand better, to be happy in life. Now, I'm not going to describe all the formulas, I'm just going to show you a few of them. It would make sense if you write your own reports, because each report is going to be kind of different for every situation. Here in the summary, we have very simple formulas. So here the start date, mentioning the date range pick one dot the first function. The end date with this almost the same formula with a different function, the last function. We've calculated the time period, end date minus start date, which are the name that we've given to our two first formula. And then we have the number of people that we have reached. We mentioned the table, we mentioned the column, and we mentioned the function. So we want the last updated query. Same for the visitors, same for the conversion, right? Now we have other formulas everywhere. So here is the number of people that we have reached for the local campaigns. So the formulas will be, this is our table where we have the data, but we want to filter that with the name and the time. So let's look at the name first. In the name, we're gonna take Berkeley because we just want to keep the Berkeley campaigns. And for that, I've used the regex match function because I name all my campaigns with Berkeley when I was campaigning locally. And I combine that with another filter to only take the last updated queries. So the formulas take the most recent date using the max function minus 2 minutes. And then I'm taking the reach of those campaigns that I sum, which is in total about 20,000 people. And then I apply the same logic for the whole funnel. I want to send that by email. So I click on Explorer, search for email, and then I just drag and drop the template email page, and I just remove the unnecessary stuff, and bam, it's done. That's it for me, guys. I hope it gave you some ideas. I'm going to share the template of Coda in the description below. If you liked it, subscribe, thumbs up, share, and brace yourself. Sometimes it's easy. We are running off.
Pourquoi ça, tu vois, ils vont dire prends le temps et tout ça, moi je trouve pas un bon argument.
Mais si, mais je le tourne en dérision. Si. T'es pas d'accord? Faut que non, je fasse. C'est de l'humour.
Je veux pas développer une app juste pour ça.